This is ONN's Campaign 2012 with Jim Heath.
There is no question that the Tea Party played a major role in helping Republican candidates get elected to a variety of offices in 2010, including a majority of seats in the U.S. House. Chris Littleton is the former president of the Ohio Liberty Council. That's a statewide coalition of Tea Party groups. He's created quite a buzz in political circles this week by writing about the death of the Tea Party. He says, quote, "The Tea Party movement is dead. It's gone. The Tea Party died because those of us who helped launch those early protests were smart enough to adapt our tactics. The Tea Party may have died and the protests may have come to an end, but the individuals who champion the cause of liberty are stronger and more effective than ever." Ohio Republican Party Chairman Kevin DeWine last week on this show dismissed Chris' proclamation, stating that he believes the Tea Party is alive and well. Chris Littleton joins us. Good to see you.
Good to see you as well.
What's been the reaction?
I get to write a lot of things, I think, is to make people think. And in this case, it was, have we thought about what we're going to be doing in 2012 and beyond? This is a huge election year, so how are we focusing our energy, those of us that were part of that Tea Party that had been around for so long? What have we done good? What have we done bad? It was very much an introspective look at where are we going as liberty groups and leaders throughout the state that are that new grassroots that kind of
sprung up. And your main point is?
My main point is that we've actually gotten a far more precise, a whole lot better at getting something done, and that something done is really focusing on securing public policy that's consistent with the things we believe in. Issue 3 is probably the most gleaming example of something that was very specific in nature that we all focused on, that was a resounding success, and at no point was it really truly a Tea Party quote-unquote issue.
When I think of the big Tea Party protests in Cincinnati and mm-hmm. at the State House, just thousands of people, mm-hmm. Republicans then won in 2010, mm-hmm. and that stopped. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's a reality here that when Republicans take control, it's hard for a lot of Tea Party members to be angry with a Republican majority, mm-hmm. right?
No, I think that's true, and that's another one of the points I wanted to make, is that this is really much, much bigger than any one candidate. And so if we're not focused on policies, actually achieving policy objectives that make sense, for those of us who truly believe that we have to uphold and focus on personal and economic freedom, those are the things that matter to us.
Tea Party didn't really find a presidential candidate.
Sure.
Was that a big factor in this year as well? I mean, if Sarah Palin had run, that would have been a no-brainer.
Yeah, I don't even know that that's true. I think that all of the candidates, certainly there is no majority candidate right now for the average liberty-minded individual that's out there.
If, for instance, there's a brokered GOP convention, is that a time where Tea Party activists could play a major role?
Very fascinating. Obviously, it depends on who's actually at the convention, who is delegates, who is active enough. And I don't think that's the average Tea Party person. I think that's actually a lot of Republican people have been there for a while.
All right, Chris Littleton, good to see you. Thank
Great,
you so
thanks
much.
So much.
Campaign 2012 with Jim Heath is presented by the Myrtle Beach Area Convention and Visitors Bureau. Go to visitmyrtlebeach.com for information to plan for your vacation.